The MiG-29 aircraft, alongside the Sukhoi Su-27, was designed to serve the Soviet Union so that it can have advantage over US fighter jets like the McDonnell Douglas F-15 Eagle and the General Dynamics F-16 Fighting Falcon. So now let's see how they compare with each other. Hey guys, this is Leroy Kenton here, and thanks for tuning in to another episode of FTD Facts. Don't forget to leave a like on this video if you love these differences episode, as well as subscribe if you are new face here to FTD Facts, and hit that bell notification as well so you don't miss any future videos like this. Now first up, I want to start off with the MiG-29. So this aircraft was developed by Mikoyan Design Bureau, and it was made for air superiority, and this was done back in the 1970s. So the Mikoyan MiG-29 is a twin-engine jet fighter designed to serve Russia, previously the Soviet Union. And one of the main advantages of the MiG-29 is its ability to fire missiles that can hit air-to-air targets outside of the line of sight. The MiG-29 is considered to be superior to other fourth-generation American and European-made fighter jets of their time. The MiG-29s have been in production since 1981 up until the present day, and the number of MiG-29s that have been built are over 1,600, and the cost to make them? Well, it's about $22 million approximately. Alright, so now let's see what the Su-27 has to offer. So the Sukhoi Su-27, also called the Flanker, is a Russian air superiority fighter plane, and this was introduced into the Air Force of the Soviet Union beginning in the year 1985. Now the Su-27 was a direct competitor with the United States' fourth generation fighters like the F-14 Tomcat and the F-15 Eagle. The Russian Air Force modified most of its existing Flankers with a variety of advanced avionics, improving its air-to-air capacity, and also giving it an effective ground attack capability. The Su-27s have been in production since 1982, and they're still in production to this day. A little over 800 of them have been built, and they're a little bit more expensive than the MiG-29s. These will run you about $30.6 million. Now let's take a look at the differences between the specs and the designs of these aircraft. For the MiG-29, it has a range of 1,430 kilometers. And when I say range, it's the distance that it can fly before it needs to refuel again. It has a maximum speed of Mach 2.25, which is 2,400 kilometers per hour, which translates to 1,490 miles. The MiG-29 has a total wingspan of 11.36 meters, which works out to be 37 feet and 3 inches. Its empty weight is about 11,000 kilograms or 24,250 pounds. It has a height of 4.73 meters or 15 feet and 6 inches. And the MiG-29's length is 17.32 meters or 56 feet and 10 inches. The service ceiling of the MiG-29 is 18,000 meters or 59,100 feet. And that is pretty much its maximum altitude. When we look at the armament of the MiG-29, it can carry one gun, and that's a 30mm Gryazev Shipunov GSH-31 autocannon with 150 rounds in it. It has 7 hard points where it can carry a combination of rockets, you know, the S-5 rockets, S-8s, and the S-24s, as well as it can carry 2 air-to-air missiles and 4 R-60 AAMs and 4 R-73 AAMs. It can also carry a total of 6 bombs weighing 665 kilograms. Now the range of the Su-27, or the distance that it can fly before it needs to refuel, is 3,530 kilometers. The maximum speed of the Su-27 is Mach 2.35, which is 2,500 kilometers per hour, or 1,550 miles per hour. It has a total wingspan of 14.7 meters, which works out to be 48 feet and 3 inches. Now the weight of the aircraft when it's not loaded with weapons or anything is 16,380 kilograms, which works out to be 36,100 pounds. The height of the aircraft is 5.92 meters, which is 19 feet and 6 inches, and it has a length of 21.9 meters, which is 72 feet. The service ceiling of the Su-27 is 19,000 meters, which is 62,500 523 feet, so it can't fly any higher than that. When it comes to the variants of these aircrafts, the MiG-29 has over 20 variants, and the SU-27 has 30 plus variants. The countries that operate MiG-29s are Russia, Ukraine, Yugoslavia, Serbia, India, Germany, Peru, Poland, Iraq, Syria, Sudan, United States, Algeria, Azerbaijan, Bangladesh, North Korea, and others. Now, which countries operate the SU-27? Well, I got a list of them right here. Those countries are Angola, China, Indonesia, Kazakhstan, Mongolia, Russia, Ukraine, Uzbekistan, Vietnam, and the United States. So in conclusion, most experts say that the SU-27 Flanker is better overall than the MiG-29 in many different aspects, and some of the aspects that they looked at include the higher engine power, the longer range endurance, so it can fly a longer distance without having to refuel, as well as its ability to carry a wide range of air-to-air missiles. The radar in the SU-27 also has a higher detection range and is able to fire ER versions of the R-27 at a further distance than the MiG-29. So that's all I have for you in this episode. Thank you so much for coming here to FTD Facts and learning with me. Be sure to follow me on social media. Those links are down below. And leave your thoughts and comments, as well as suggestions of new videos that you would like to see. So until next time, my name is Leroy Kenton. You've been awesome, and I'll see you real soon in another episode. If you enjoyed this video, here are some playlists that I recommend of more military episodes, as well as more differences between videos as well. And just a reminder to come back here to FTD Facts each day for new episodes.